Thank you for being here so late. This is the normal exit announcement. Should already know about it. And this is my talk, how safe networking could solve your environment-specific use case. Before I go into about me, my name is Konstantinos Karampogias. I'm working for Swisscom. And the last 2 years, I have been actively involved in the open source Cloud Foundry team. First, I started doing my dojo in the CF networking team, where I got familiar with a pre-silk version of it. Then I joined the current team in London remotely, where I got some good knowledge about how containers are working. And now I'm part of the CFCR team, remote member in Dublin. And this is my GitHub and my Twitter. The agenda of our presentation is straightforward. We are going to discuss about our problem that we need to solve. Then we are going to discuss the two things that make it possible to give our solution. And this is the CF networking boss release and the change CNI plugin feature. We are going through then the custom stack of the prototype. We will do a demo, we will conclude, and we will have time for some questions. So the problem that we want to solve is called external traffic identification, according to which, if two apps are running in the same Diego cell, we cannot, and these apps are trying to speak to an external service, the service owner cannot identify the traffic, cannot say that this traffic comes from a production app or this traffic is coming from a non-production app. Why this is happening? It's happening because if we see the traffic inside the Diego cell, we can see that there are two source IP addresses, and it's easy to map. But once we go outside the Diego cell, the traffic has been masked. So we now see only the external IP of the Diego cell. Of course, when we go outside the operator gateway, same stuff. This time, the external IP is a public IP of the operator. So it goes to the gateway in the service where we say what's happening. How can we actually put a rule that it will say, okay, I want to allow traffic only from my production app. This is also the requirement from the customer, that he wants to put a traditional firewall rule. And in order to do that, we need actually to split the traffic all the way through from the source. Basically, we need to be able to put in our gateway, in the operator gateway, another rule that will say that if I have a production app, please put this source IP address. And then it goes to the question, how do we do that in our network, in the custom operator network? And this is the custom behavior that you want to add. This behavior probably will not make sense to do it in the upstream. It will not be accepted. So, I decided that I would like to solve this problem by simply controlling the source port range from the traffic. So I want to have a rule that it will say, if I have a production app, put this specific source port range. This will work because then it will be easy in the gateway to put if this source port range, 5,000 to 5,100, put this production IP, and then advertise this production IP to the customer, and the customer will put the rule. So now the question is, how do I do that in the CF platform? Before I will present my solution, this kind of alternative that I have discussed over the last year. Have two separate safe deployments. This might make sense if we have quite a large customer. Alternative is to have isolation segments by having only specific subset of the Diego cell running the production app, we could just differentiate the IP. But resource-wise might not be optimal. From the network perspective, probably this is a better solution, which says that I'm going to put the operator gateway inside the container network. But given that this gateway might be an expensive hardware device, this is not very applicable. And there is also, of course, the service mesh that is going to solve everything, and this is correct, but this will make the assumption that we will open up and we'll have our customer to trust this. Plus, this is a very simple use case to actually try to introduce service mesh just to solve that. two things happened that we could address the problem with another way. The CF networking stack changed. The CF networking team replaced the old Kawasaki stack and on one side enabled the direct communication, so make the microservice experience better, low latency. But in my context, what it basically did, it added a CNI pluggable endpoint in the platform. So it added one component that is called Garden External Networker, and this is part with the Garden Run C, the runtime. It put an interface that is the CNI interface, and it added a battery included solution that is the red part here. So, and said that by having the ability to provide a plugin that is according to the CNI standard, then you can actually replace and put your stuff here. A bit about the container network interface. This is the interface that is happening between the runtime and the net plugin. So it tries to standardize the network implementation and make the code base of the runtime smaller, cleaner, and allow more network ventures to add a plugin. It's simple because it needs only one config file that is fed to the runtime. Then with some runtime environments, there is just a call in a standard call in the plugin, and we set up the network. CNI is not what solved my use case. It is a new feature that is called chaining. So now it allows actually to call more than one plugin. Let's see a bit how it works, just as refreshment. We start by having one configuration file. We feed this configuration file to the runtime. The runtime then creates the container during the run COCI call, gets back the network namespace. This is only what it needs. Then it's going to create a STD that it will feed to the binary, that it will take the configuration file and the runtime information. The most important is the network namespace, and it's going to call the CNI plugin. The CNI plugin is going to do what it needs to do to connect the container, the network namespace into the network, and it's going to return. But now, in the chaining feature, this changes. So instead of having one configuration file, now basically have a conf list. So it's saying that you're going to call three plugins with three configuration. So the first step stays as it is. But now, instead of exiting, the runtime is going to take the previous results from the first call and is going to call the second plugin. It will get the results back, call the third plugin. So the network stack. For the version that I started working on that, the Garden External Networker did not work out of the box. I had to modify it. But the changes that I did were minimal. So basically, instead of calling the conf from the standard library, it's to call the conf list. And this was all what I had to do. Then I start building my chain. So I put first one binary that is called bridge that takes care of the connectivity. This is an open source binary maintained by the container networking team. On the right, you can see the configuration file that this plugin requires. Then I added another binary that is the IP mask, the port map. This is also an open source. This is the plugin that basically controls all the traffic that flows in the container. It's how I'm going to access the container, the process that is running inside the container. On the right is the configuration file that needs to run. Here you can see that there is something that is capabilities port mapping equals true. So what does it mean? It means that during the runtime should expand this and provide some more information to the plugin. And the case is like which host port in the Diego cell to bind, which internal port of the container, and which port protocol. By having done that, I keep the CF push working. And then I start adding my own stuff. So I wrote a small plugin that I called IP mask. So the intention of this is to control the traffic that flows from the container outside. Here is the configuration file that needs. It needs this time something different that is called mask entries. And during runtime, this has been expanded to give me the source port range that I want to attach to this container. In this moment, it became clear that it's very easy to add behavior. So I said, OK, let's experiment a bit more. So I added another plugin that I called IP route. So this is what it's doing, is basically control the routing table of the container. And again, this in order to work, it has to feed some information routes. What I have in mind when I was writing this plugin is if I can replace the application security groups to use the routing table instead of IP tables for performance reason. I was keep going, so I just create another binary that I call DNS register. So what this is doing is just taking the metadata of the container, the application ID, and then register itself to the console that already exists in the Cloud Foundry. And because it was a bit hard to debug stuff, I wrote one other plugin that basically what it's doing is just writing in the disk all the configuration file. So it was easy for me to debug this black box. A such plugin might be interesting also for auditing reason. And yes, I took that, I created a custom boss release, which basically deploys the Gardner Excel networker, all my binaries, my configuration files, and does some pre-steps. And then I just add another ops file, which basically saying just enable my CF extended networking. The demo. The demo, I could not do it in my boss slide because basically I could not attach two public IPs to my laptop. So I picked AWS. So I did just a bubble app. I deploy CF. I register my DNS domain. And then manually, I had to add two external IP addresses in the NAT instance. In the NAT instance that we see, it's from where all the traffic goes out of the container. And then on the other side, I just built one MariaDB service in a server where I control the IP tables rules. And then I just deployed the CF external networking. Now I can do the small demo. So we see here that I have the boss VMs. I have two Diego cells. I have login in my Cloud Foundry. And I have two spaces, one dev and one production. The first thing that I have to do is basically to create the mapping, so to say that this production unit should be mapped to this port range, 5,000, 5,100. I do that, and I have to do that also for the dev space. So the dev space will take a different port range. Once I do that, I basically have to deploy. So I'm not going to deploy for timing reasons, but it's just a call that I'm using in my ops file, and I'm just doing a boss deploy. And the ops file is just replacing this, adding my custom boss release. And yes, when I will deploy, I could just go to the Diego cell to show you what exactly happened. So it added the binaries that I'm going to use. This is all the binaries that I described before. It added the configuration, the mapping. So we jobs. Config mask rule. So you see here that this saying which page will take which source port range. And there is also the configuration file that is exactly what I presented in the slides before. So now I'm ready to deploy an app. So basically I'm going to the production. Oops, sorry. Prod. In the prod, then I'm going to do a push prod. I'm going to do a no start, because before I have to do to set up an environment variable where to actually connect to the external service. And then I can just start it. This should take a bit of time. And then I have, okay. Yes, so it seems that I have insufficient resource. But I have another app that is running that is called Prod App, and it's in this space. And I can also see that I have in the dev space another app that is called Dev App. So if I do a curl to the Dev App, I should see that it's forbidden. And if I do the same call to the Prod App, I should see that again it's failing. But this time I can see that my IP is different from this case. So now I have to take this IP and just give it to the MySQL operator, to basically the network guy that fixed the rules. So what it has to be done, basically, to add a rule that is going to allow the traffic from only one IP address. So when I do that, and I do the curve from here, I can see that now there is a connection succeeded, and I can get the result back from the MariaDB, while the other one still is failing. And the same stuff I can do if I clicked here, also to see it in the dev app, fails, prod app, succeeds. So this probably is very useful, because almost all the container-based orchestrator have this problem. And what happened? Okay. So one thing that I want also to show is if I do an SSH CF TAF S prod CFA CFSH prod up, and I'm inside here, and I can do the IP route. I can see that basically I have control the routing table. This one entry that I just put inside. And if I do the same here, but in the dev space, and I do an SSH dev up, then I can also see that the DNS registration works. So basically, if I take this and then I do a NS lookup dot service dot cf dot internal, I should be able to see that I have registered and I have provided DNS names. And the ping also still works. So before I conclude, I would like just to show you how things actually implemented in the Diego Self site. So in all, everything takes place in this post-routing TAFNAT, where basically I'm adding my rule in front of everything else. And then I add all the information that I need here, with saying which port range will take. And so this is very flexible, because at the end of the day, I can put whatever kind of IP telnet rules I want that to work only with a specific container. And if I see also the big up that CNI, the net part, I can see how it looks like the actual call. So this is basically how the runtime is extending stuff. So from the configuration file that was the capabilities port mapping equals true, the runtime has to expand it and give the actual information. To go back to our presentation, I don't need the recording one. So we have to discuss a bit the user interface. In the demo, there were two things that I did not like. And this is the fact that I had to do a boss deploy in order to add the mapping. This is not the way to do it. And also I had to modify the code of the CF, of the garden network external networker, because I had to do this small task, like take this map and take my space ID and find which is my source port range, in order to produce finally what the plugin needs to work. And this is not ideal, because this information should not be relevant to the platform. It is only a contract between the plugin and the operator or the user. So as a user interface, in my use case, would have been to have a command like that, for example, that I will do a CF, set space metadata, CNARCs, and then whatever I want, that I know that this information will pass and go in the plugin and will be interpreted correctly. In the future, I would like to see the garden, the CF networking team, to adapt a native chain CNI, and I think they have already started looking at it. I would like to see to replace the bridge with a silk, because this will allow us to keep all the policy framework and everything as it is working now. And I will be curious how we will be able to change the behavior as far as the traffic goes out, the routing table, and the traffic goes in real time. Because when we are using CNI, it's only about the calls that we are doing when we create or we delete the container. It does not have to do with the real time. So if we implement something there, we have always to restage our apps. And this is not ideal. And of course, to investigate how these things could or are working out of the box in a Kubernetes cluster. Here are some links. One is one talk from the previous summit where I explained more about the CNI. The second link is a blog that explains a bit more details how a runtime is using the CNI and the chaining one. And the source code of my demo. In the first one is all the CNI plugins that I used. And the second one, it's the boss release. Probably it's not going to work out of the box because of the blobs, but should be good enough. Yes, and that was my talk. Thank you very much.